Got the amp.
I got the Fosi Audio 30B Pro.
Cool.
Got the review.
Yeah, here you go. Thanks. Hello, everybody. NewsBoy Audio here. Back with you for a new review. Got my pants on, so it's review time. Today we got you the Fosi Audio BT30D Pro. This is a new device by Fosi Audio. I did want to disclose that Fosi Audio provided this device to me for this review and for me to play with it. But under the condition that I would not change my review whatsoever, and that this review would be 100% honest about this device. Fosi Audio made a wonderful little D-class amp with a Bluetooth 5.0 receiver. And the device works absolutely stunning with both Android and iPhone. Also, it works great with computers, PC. I have not tested it with a Macintosh because I do not have a Macintosh, but I would assume it would also work because this shows up as a standard Bluetooth audio device. This is a wonderful little box that I got from Fosi Audio, which is a Chinese company. And inside of it, they had this, device and a little inscription box. The power supply was over here and the device was over here. It's actually a nice little storage container, and I plan on keeping this with the device because I can always put it back in there if I'm not using it. Let's talk about first the power supply. The power supply is a 5-amp, 32-volt power supply. It has a little adapter, D-dongle adapter, that you plug in the back of it. There are some reports for other devices that Fosi has produced that some of these devices were a little noisy and produced a ripple effect. I am not sure if that is the case with this one. There are higher performance power adapters out there. So keep an eye out and look for those if you want to push the performance a little bit further. You may be able to. But understand that this device is only so effective. The device itself is absolutely stunning. It's a little device that, right here. It's got these nice high quality knobs up here. And the Fosi Audio language up here with a nice power switch here that's nice and silver. I love the tiny little size of this. I'm absolutely amazed they were able to fit so much into such a little tiny box. On the back end, we have a line level inputs. We also have a preamp output. And we've got three speaker terminals. We got right and left, which are both at 50 watts. And we got the subwoofer, which will power a passive subwoofer at 100 watts. If you want to use an active subwoofer, you will want to use the preamp outputs into your subwoofer, and then you can use an active amplifier through that means. But it also accepts a line input. On the front, we've got subwoofer frequency, which allows you to adjust the crossover for the frequency within the device. If you're using, again, the level out, it probably will not cut that off. You also have a sub volume here, and you have a treble and bass control, as well as your power, okay? And on the back, you got a nice big Bluetooth antenna for connecting to your phone. Now, maybe this device isn't for you. Maybe you need something a little bit different. Maybe you need a subwoofer out on here. Maybe you need a USB input for a DAC or an optical DAC. There are other devices that use the same configuration of Bluetooth 5.0 that Fosi makes, and they offer those additional connections on here, but you lose the preamp out, which I really do like, especially given the fact that I could use this just as a Bluetooth receiver on many devices when I just want to connect my phone, play some music, and enjoy it. I have connected with both iPhone, Android, and PC. I just have not connected with a Macintosh. It shows up as a regular Bluetooth speaker or headphones, and you can play music with it without installing any drivers, which is very nice. The one problem that I've had with this is that the microphone itself, or the device setup itself, does not ask for any passwords or verifications. So if you leave this on and you're not connected to it, your neighbors could possibly connect it to it and start playing music to your device. So it's important to either turn it off or stay connected with your device when you're using it. Otherwise, you might wake up in the middle of the night to some joker that finds your device, plugs into it, and starts playing music through it, which would be kind of funny, actually. It's one of the few things that I found that was a problem with it. We also tested it to see if it suffered from the previous problems that other Fosies have had, including disconnecting it from Bluetooth and checking it for every single aspect of operational as well. We were not able to get any distortion or any fuzz out of this, even when the Bluetooth disconnected. It performed excellent in every situation, and I'm absolutely fantastic by this. Some wonderful use case situations that this could be on. You can tape this to the back of a pair of speakers, and you can make a pair of Bluetooth speakers that only uses one wire between the two of them. You can run one wire down to your main speaker and one wire to the other speaker. Makes for a great portable speaker. Say you go on vacation and want to bring some speakers with you, you can do that. Just plop it in there, throw this small little tiny device in there, and bring it with you. And you've got amazing quality audio anywhere you want to go. What we're ultimately probably going to end up using this for is using those JVCs that I have a review for, the wood cone. We're going to plug this in, and my wife's going to enjoy it on her computer. She's going to be able to play all the music that she wants wirelessly through the Bluetooth, and it's going to sound absolutely great. Very impressed by the Fosi Audio Bluetooth 20D Pro. How does it perform? Well, actually, I'm very surprised. For a $90 amplifier, and you've seen my reviews, I've not reviewed any amplifier that isn't under a couple $100, probably $300, $400, $500 is the minimum amplifier. This sounds damn good. I am very, very impressed, and it really speaks to me at how far these digital processors work, which, by the way, is a Texas Instrument processor in this. They've really come quite a long ways, and they've been able to perform very, very well. When I initially plugged it into my speakers themselves are the HiFi 2.1As, and they are renowned for being a little bit bright. Plugging it into this, and I must say, initially, it sounded like a tin can. I was very disappointed. So I let it play out, and I let it burn in, and it warmed up a little bit. In addition, I was able to adjust the treble a little bit and bring that bass up that the heavies really need. And this really helped those speakers perform And eventually I was able to get top quality performance out of it for such a low price. Would I replace my ABs and my higher end amplifiers? Probably not. Not with this one. But with that said, I am very impressed for the price that this sells for. Amazon has it at about $105 right now. Sometimes they go on sale for a little bit less. It performs very, very good. Please like and subscribe my videos. I am looking to grow, and I am looking to make this channel more and more. And please share my videos as well. That really helps out. If you are in a Facebook group or something else, please share it.